And we're going to go. This is ERAO cranial, and you will see that the LAD has a long disease from the proximal and mid segment, and actually in the distal end of the vessel becomes normal. So we're talking about a long calcified disease in the proximal and mid LAD. We're seeing already there is some calcium in angiography, but we're going to further refine that analysis, of course. And here we see an LAO cranial with more or less the same information. There are three diagonal branches. These diagonal branches are small. We have quantified the myocardial mass with CT, and these are small territories. So I think that the strategy that we have defined together with Emanuele is to go
pressure measurement. The tip, we are ready for the equalization. We can perform the equalization again. There we go, we have a one. So I will insert again the needle in the hemostatic valve here. You know, when we do this exercise, what we like to do is flush the guiding catheter with from any residual of contrast medium. There is some tortuosity there. I will do very gentle movement. And of course, there are lots of septal branches and diagonal branches on the way. We try to avoid visiting all of them. There we go. I think we are good enough.
Good. So we have positioned the wire distal in the vessel. Now we're going to proceed to measure FFR. I'm going to flush the system with saline. This is to obtain high quality pressure traces. And this is an important step to avoid artifact. It is we have a stable pullback until the tip of the pressure wire. And you'll see immediately how it's a big jump in the mid LAD and some diffuse disease in the proximal LAD. And we're going to be prepared to click on the stop button as soon as the sensor reaches the catheter tip, which is now stop. And look at this pullback. This is a perfect pullback. You see that the morphology, there is no artifacts, and you see immediately we calculate the PPG, and in this case, the PPG is 54. But if we go beyond that and we look at the red mountains below in the coroventris, we see that there are two places where the pressure is being lost. In other words, there are two places where there are significant lesions from the functional perspective. In the mid segment is the worst lesion, is the one that we see in angiography in the mid, but there are also some diffuse pressure losses proximally. And when you see the physiology,
we already right, so pull it back a bit.
It's very proximal.
Yeah, indeed, indeed. But that's actually what I expected. So what I will do, I will advance the catheter a bit more and try again.
The first acquisition pathology behind this lesion. So this is the first screen of the new software of the Ultrium. So you see it's only telling you which type of pullback. I'm going to select 75 millimeters. We're going to see a long part of the vessel. I'm going to click proceed. Then the software will ask us if we are happy with the amount of contrast in the vessel or blood. We're happy with this. So we're ready to go, Emanuele. We're calibrating and you can start. I'm going to trigger the pullback manual. That is a beautiful opacification, Emanuele. I think we have a very high quality pullback, and we're going to be able to make a very nice analysis of the plaque. So the first step in this new layout of the software is to accept actually the quality of the pullback. So I'm just going to accept and continue. The next point is to actually inform the system where is the vessel to perform the co-registration. So I'm going to put a point in the proximal part of the vessel, and I'm going to point another point in the distal part of the vessel. And we will just have to check the center line that actually goes in the path that we have selected, and this is correct. And you see that I'm going to confirm now. And then the core research is being performed. So now we're going to start our analysis. And just for all of us, or for the ones that are starting in the imaging field, it's very easy to go through the algorithm of MLD Max to understand the steps that we have to follow in order to assess all type of lesions. What comes in this new software, Emanuele, is that it helps us to identify automatically, based on artificial intelligence, the amount of calcium that we have in the coronary vessel. And that, if you see our longitudinal plane, and now I'm going to go into the OCT image, you see that is the typical OCT image, but in the longitudinal plane, you have new things. And these orange markers are just telling you where the calcium is more than 180 degrees. When I look at calcium, there are three things that I want to know. I want to know the arc, I want to know the thickness, and I want to know the length. These are the three things that can help us decide whether this patient needs an additional therapy, which in this case was already performed. So I'm going to drive you through the pullback, Emanuele. I'm going to start with the proximal part. This is the proximal LAD. Looks healthy from three to nine. But I have to tell you, Emanuele, that just at the level of the ostium of the LAD, I see a huge dissection. And this might be related to the use of the guide extension catheter. There we go, more proximally. Here you see at 270 degrees of calcium with a thickness of 1.3, but I'm pretty happy to inform you that there is a fracture of the calcium at 9 o'clock. Therefore, we're gonna be able to expand our stent at this level. We further continue analyzing the plaque, and I'm gonna go to the MLA. Here we see another dissection, probably induced either by the rota or the previous balloon dilatations. And this is the place where we were struggling. Emanuele, there in this specific spot, I have to tell you that we have no fractures of the calcium. So I see 360 degrees of calcium. The system is detecting 260 degrees, a little bit more, but that is because of the artifact of the guide wire. I have to tell you that the thickness, according to the machine, is 0.9 at the level of the arrowhead. So it's a thick calcium, circumferential, and it's more than 5 millimeters in length. So this is indeed where we're having so much difficulty getting the material down the vessel. So this is following the MLD max algorithm, the M of morphology. Now we're going to step to the next step of the algorithm, that is the L. It refers to the length of the stent and, of course, the size of the balloon that we're gonna use or the stent. And this is the new layout of the Ultrion 1.0. You see, again, three cross sections. The first cross section refers to the position when the proximal landing zone is placed. The second cross section in the middle panel refers to the MLA or the MLD. And the last cross section refers to the place where is the distal landing zone. You'll see here that the system tried to guide us, but indeed the disease is longer than this. So the first thing I'm gonna do is to start looking for a healthy landing zone distal. And I have to go very distal. Here in the vessel, you see at this moment, this dash white line is the indicator of EEL, and this is automatically assessed by the system. So in this case, the EEL in the distal landing zone is 3.09, meaning that we have to select the stent that is one matrix of the stent size below, that is 3.0. So that's the stent diameter that we're gonna use. And I'm gonna select this one as my distal landing zone. Why? Because all of this is full of disease. And then of course, there is the MLA here, which is actually a ring of calcium. We'll need to fix it before putting the next stent. And I would suggest that we need to cover this vessel until the very ostium of the LAD, mainly because there is a dissection in the proximal part of the vessel, probably induced by the guideline. So I'm gonna select the length here and the length at this cross section, Emanuele. And at this level, we have already a EL to EL of 4.4. And that also informs me before I do my final OCT, what is the balloon that I have to select for the optimization in the proximal part of the vessel. So I'm thinking in the MLD algorithm, in the L, length, size. Size of what? Size of the stent, length and diameter, but also size of the balloon for proximal optimization, which is gonna be a 4. And then I'm gonna just place my second marker here, and we're talking about a region of approximately 63 millimeters in length, which is the necessary length to cover the complete plaque.
Dear Emanuele, Carlos, and colleagues, that indeed is a very complex and demanding case with a number of important teachings.
G is telling us is the geography of the functional coronary artery disease. So in a way, very practically, is telling us whether in a functionally significant stenosis, let's start from this background, PPG applies to functionally significant stenosis. So when FFR is below 0.8, and in this way, we address also one of the questions coming from the community. So in that case, when we have a stenosis and FFR is below 0.8, what PPG is telling us on top is whether we can help these patients by implanting a stent, because we are dealing with focal atherosclerotic disease. And that is the case when PPG is above 0.5. At the variance with a PPG below 0.5, that is practically informing us that we are dealing with a diffuse coronary atherosclerotic disease. And in that second case, even if we implant a stent, it's very unlikely that with a segmental treatment, we can improve much the functional result of that particular PCI. Carlos, if you want to add more, just take over.
No, I think you captured the two main elements, Emanuele. So I agree with Dr. Pirot that we are moving physiology from a diagnostic tool that helps us decide whether we need to treat that patient, yes or no, based on the significance of the lesion, towards using physiology to help us guide and plan our interventions. So it's indeed a second dimension that we are adding to our physiological tools to help us do better PCI.
Thank you very much. Carlos, could you also summarize for us the new features of the Ultrion software in a nutshell in 1 minute?
Well, the major feature that has the new software is actually the automatic calcium detection. This is helping you in the procedure to in a very fast fashion assess the amount of calcium that you have in one place. If I would have to take one element, it would be the automatic calcium detection.
Thank you very much. Time is running. So, dear colleagues, thank you very much for this instrumental discussion. And now I'm asking Dr.